Here, Dr. K.M. Sumathi, Assistant Professor of English, much delighted in welcoming you all for this third day national virtual seminar series on the role of literature and life management in pandemic, organized by the Department of English. What is pandemic? Pandemic is an outbreak of a disease that spreads across countries and continents. Some of the very worst pandemics are Black Death, Spanish Flu, Plague, AIDS, and at present, novel coronavirus. The corona or COVID-19 pandemic has led to a dramatic loss of human life worldwide and presents an unprecedented challenge to public health, food system, and world of work. The economic and social disruption caused by the pandemic is devastating. Without the means to earn an income during lockdowns, many are unable to feed themselves and their families. For most, no income means no food. Apart from the socio and economic problems, this pandemic has also induced fear, worry, and concern in the population at large. And most of us are psychologically into depression. With this succinct intro, let me invite our persuasive, considerate, sincere, dear ma'am, Dr. G.S. Angelin, head of the Department of English, to deliver welcome address and introduce the chief guest. Please, ma'am.
Thank you, dear Dr. Sumathi. Respected and beloved principal of our college, esteemed chief guest, members of the teaching fraternity, and my dear students and scholars, I wish you all a very good morning. I am immensely pleased to welcome our principal, Dr. V. Anuradha, who is a great boon to our institution. Her encouragement and industrious nature motivates all of us towards sustained work for our institution and for our students. She has spared her valuable time to preside over this session and give the presidential address. I render a very warm welcome to you, madam. It is my special privilege to welcome the resource person, Dr. Amar Singh, Professor and Head, Department of English, Government Autonomous Postgraduate Lead College, Chindwara, Madhya Pradesh. He has 28 years of teaching experience with a remarkable record of participating in 300 national and international seminars and training programs. He owns the credit of delivering 300 motivational lectures during the pandemic alone. In the last decade, he has delivered 1,500 motivational lectures. He has published 80 papers at national and international levels. His contribution to the examination and evaluation section is immense, for he has got the credit of being an examiner for evaluating PhD thesis in 11 universities. He has been a research supervisor for 18 MPhil and 8 PhD scholars. His areas of specialization includes communication skills, life management skills, self-empowerment, and personality development training, and British fiction. He has been a member and chairman in the board of studies of different institutions. He has made significant contribution to NSS, Election Commission, and developmental schemes of the government as a trainer. We are fortunate to have such a multifaceted personality as a resource person of today's session. My hearty welcome to you, sir. It is my bounden duty and joy to welcome all the teaching fraternity of our college. Last but not the least, I welcome the students and scholars who will be benefited out of this session. My amiable welcome to all of you. Once again, I welcome you one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, dear Dr. Angeline. Thank you so much, ma'am. Action is a real measure of intelligence. We should feel proud to have an intelligent and highly resourceful, respected dear ma'am principal, Dr. V. Anuradha, whose action is always a real measure to the success of the college. I am profoundly delighted to invite our respected principal ma'am to deliver presidential address. Ma'am, please.
Thank you, Dr. Sumati. Good morning, everybody. Hope you all are doing well. As a language and literature teacher, I'm very much happy to preside over this session today. On behalf of our MVM family, I welcome our remarkable chief guest, Dr. Rama Singh, Professor and HOD of English, Government Autonomous PG League College, Chindwara, Madhya Pradesh, who is going to share his views on the role of literature and life management in pandemic. A warm welcome to you, sir. Literature. Literature is a 10-lettered magic word which can do wonders in the world. It's a 10-lettered poem. It's a 10-lettered short story. It's a 10-lettered novel. It's a 10-lettered fiction. It has no time bounds. It lives forever. It shows not only mankind's life, but also all kinds of living and non-living things' lives through its lingual styles. It reflects its period as a mirror. In Tamil, it is quoted as Ilakkiyam Enbadu Kalam Kattum Kannadi. Literature can structure or restructure not even societies, countries, but also the whole world. Wise men think alike. Likewise, literature people also think alike all over the world. If we want to smile, literature can smile. If we want to cry, literature can cry. If we want to get angry, literature can get angry. If we want to express our agonies, literature can express our agonies. So, we can't discriminate our lives from literature. In this pandemic period, it is an essential topic to be discussed, I think. Dear students, make use of this session properly. All the best to you. I appreciate Dr. Angeline, HOD of English, who delivered welcome address and introduced our chief guest, Professor P. Hemalatha, Assistant Professor in English, who is going to deliver a vote of thanks, and all the staff members of English department. Again, I thank you one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, dear ma'am, for your succinct definition for the term literature. Literature is a very big term, but you made it a very meaningful explanation, and you put it everything in a nutshell. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. The words that enlighten the soul are more precious than jewels. I am extremely honored to invite our today's chief guest, Dr. Amar Singh, Professor and Head Department of English, Government Autonomous PG Level College, Chindwara, Madhya Pradesh, to deliver a lecture on the role of literature and life management in pandemic and enlighten our soul. Sir, at this juncture, I would like to thank you for having such topic, because this topic is very, very unique and created a very long awaited expectation from you. The platform is yours, sir. Please proceed.
Thank you, ma'am. Am I audible and visible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The topic of today's lecture is the role of literature and life management in pandemic. I want to thank the organizers of this very lecture by M.B. Muthaiya Government Arts College for Women, Dindugal Department of English. I especially want to thank Dr. G.S. Angelin, Assistant Professor and HOD of English, Dr. V. Anuradha, ma'am, Principal of the institution, Dr. K.M. Sumathi, Assistant Professor English. She happens to be the organizing secretary, along with Professor P. Hemlatha, Assistant Professor English. My dear friends, professors, listeners from all over India, my dear students, as Principal Ma'am and other speakers have revealed the secret why we should study literature. Principal Ma'am has especially described that if we weep, literature covers our weeping into words. So whatever we do, that is covered, that is described, revealed, and narrated in literature. So literature is the story of our happiness, our sorrows, our disappointments, our ideological fight against all odds of life, our strategies. Most of the students who are listening to me belong to English literature. So I want to remind them some lines by Robert Browning. I think that is the real objective behind studying any language or literature. I want to quote Browning. "I was ever a fighter, so one fight more, the best is yet to be." Literature teaches us the fighting strategies, capacities, fighting measures, how to fight out all odds of life. Once we are born, it is not in our hand to win over circumstances. The circumstances are God-given, nature-given, but one thing is in our hand. That is our situation, our condition, our ways of handling any tragedy. There is no particular definition of life also. In Macbeth, William Shakespeare writes a very beautiful definition of literature and life also. "Life is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing." There is a lot of noise in our life, but having least significance of all those noises. The mind is its own place. Milton also says, once our mind is settled, all the odds, challenges, problems of our lives also get settled. So the mind is its own place that can make heaven of hell and hell of heaven. whatever happens in our mind, that is the byproduct of our mind and our attitude, our ideas. Human beings are creator of creative ideas. So whatever ideas we create, we can create the novel things, the innovative things. And if our ideas are negative and destructive, we can destroy the creativity of our life. There is nothing, Shakespeare again defines, there is nothing either good or bad, but thinking makes it so. Generally, we define this is good, this that is bad. But this is not true. Universally, one man's food is another man's poison. If somebody likes something, others hate it. So how to take out the best idea just to live our life in an embellished manner, in a modern manner? Shakespeare also says, some are born great, some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them. Man is the maker of his own fate. Others also say, what is fated cannot be blotted. So how to settle the best gist just to live our life in the best manner, that is the right and pertinent objective of our life. Napoleon also says, historical king, Napoleon said, the impossible is a thing to be found in the dictionary of fools. Nothing is impossible. The problem, again Shakespeare says, the problem is not in our stars, the problems lies in us. If our thinking patterns are not meaningful, relevant, in the right perspective, in the right direction, we ourselves are going to create great tragedies for our life. There is problem in the pattern of our thinking. Because while living in this very universe, we have impact of different people, of different situations, different things. In this way, we are conditioned. Ours is the conditioned personality, while we have to go out of all the conditioned things, because the definition of literature is to explore maximum potentialities for a bright career, for a beautiful living, for a model living or iconic living or heroic living. So style is the man himself. Only style is remembered, the person is not remembered, his ideas are remembered. So we have to improve the quality of our ideas. Once we improve the quality of our ideas, automatically all the things will improve. Again, literature. In this way, literature plays a very decisive role in the formation of a nation, in the formation of our character. Literature is the expression of the different authors who get different experiences out of the different events and different situations. How literature helps and how our literature can help win over the pandemic situation, the side effects, the pessimistic impact of pandemic, how can literature deal? It can deal because literature simplifies the complexity of human conflicts. We all are passing through human conflicts. What we should do, hopefully, others say others are very much having negative thoughts. So literature is a reflection of humanity and a way to understand each other. Again, literature develops a rare capacity to read the minds of others, to know the perspective of others, to cultivate empathy. It is a critical opinion, analytical opinion, well settled in our notion that we are not what we think of ourselves. We are always judged by others. When we become self-centered, a problem arises, and the problem is that only we give preference to our thinking. But this is not true. Just to succeed in life, we have to know others' perspective also, others' opinion also. The root of all the contentions, all the debate, all the conflicts, all the evils is not knowing the perspective, the likes and dislikes of others. So literature gives us modernist perspective that is transgressive, and literature penetrates the public consciousness. Language and literature awaken our consciousness, and of the awakened consciousness is the ultimate objective of getting any type of education. So significance of literature in the life management, in solving the crisis management, is the prioritized objective to inspire the mass, to cultivate nation building ideas, character building ideas, problem solving ideas. My dear friends, literature reflects cultural values as a tool for teaching values. Since we all belong to education as teachers and taught, so literature specifically reflects our cultural values, and cultural values are the storehouse or treasury of the matured wisdom which can never fail while solving the problems of human life. Literature specifically teaches what changes the world in a revolutionized manner. Again, literature helps us to express nationalist ideas, and the nationalist ideas give voice to the voiceless people. It is the duty of literature, it is the duty of literary ideas. The author also emphasizes to give voice to the voiceless people, to give ideas to the people who don't have proper ideas, adequate ideas, and significant ideas. Literature is a powerful method, powerful storytelling method. It is a technology that unites us across space and time. I am speaking from Madhya Pradesh as a professor, as an orator. You people are listening to me from Tamil Nadu, and others may be listening from all over India and across the border also. So sharing literary ideas, sharing literary thoughts is a powerful storytelling, convincing technology that unites the whole humanity across space and time. In our Sanskrit literature also, I think there is a lot of use of Sanskrit ideas in Tamil literature also. I want to remember and respect Subramanyam Bharati. He has been a scholarly poet of Tamil Nadu. So literature is a powerful method. It reflects our lives. It explores timeless values. Whatever ideas literature reflects, the ideas have value of timelessness. Again, the question arises, why we should study literature? Literature helps in communication skill. It helps in improving writing, speaking, and reading skills also. Literature helps us about knowing ourselves. Throughout our life, we try to know others and give the judgment where others should judge. Others should improve their ways. But the problem remains behind that. We know that which person should improve which thing, but very little we know where we should improve our own faulty ways of understanding the things. So literature teaches us about ourselves, about self, about knowing oneself. Realization of the self is the real value of any literary reading. Literature teaches us about the past wisdom. We bring past wisdom as a lively and vibrant prudence in present also. Literature gives us a universal world view. What is the Indian view of thinking? What is the Western view of thinking? Eastern, Western, and how different people of different nations think. Literature helps us understand all these things. Literature promotes the interests of a particular nation, gaining and maintaining the nation's sovereignty also. Literature encapsulate the knowledge of its intellectuals, which if repeatedly taught to the new generation, the preservation of their culture and heritage will become easy. Literature is directly related to shaping the civilizations. Literature shapes civilizations, changes political system, and exposes the injustices also. Literature gives us a preview of human experiences. By reading literature, by reading narratives, we understand each other. Literature is always thought-provoking. It allows us to raise our questions. We can raise our standard to the extent of asking the questions. The in-depth level of our asking the questions that paves the way for our future developments. So literature is thought-provoking. It allows us to raise questions, and literature gives us deeper understanding of issues and situations. Since we all are passing through pandemic situation, we have been facing, the whole humanity have been facing the different types of tragedies and challenges, and ultimate the human beings have emerged winner. So how to emerge as a winner out of this tragedy, that is the question. So how education and our literature will help, I will like to throw light on those very ideas. Literature provides an opportunity to further one's education, to expose a plethora of ideas. Literature provides alternatives of ideas. Literature is the study of human nature through human drama, tragedy, comedy, poems, stories, essays, etc. So literature instills the virtues of heroes. It is the high time that we instill the virtues of heroism in moments of crisis or during the process of cowardice. It is high time we live with the higher values of life, refined values of life. Literature helps us analyze the character. Literature is a driving force. it drives us move forward. Literature openly acknowledges the unreliable nature of appearances. We know that appearances are always deceptive. So what is hidden behind all deceptive appearances, only literature can tell. Because literature exposes the infinity to us. We all are suffering from the side effects, the crisis of pandemic, because we are not infinite. So literature provides us measures to be infinite. Literature helps us know to take maximum success out of minimum resources. So literature is always open to interpretation, explanation, annotation, and argumentation. So in this way, literature is a study of human relationship. Now, I would like to discuss how we can form our character, how we can change our attitude, because I have already told that if we fail to plan, we plan to fail. First of all, we generally use 4 to 6% of the higher capabilities of our mind. So it is up to us to use maximum human potentialities of our mind to solve the problems. When we work half-heartedly, when we plan half-heartedly, we emerge failure. So just to become successful, there are some literary ideas I'm going to discuss with you. And those ideas will help win this very pandemic tragedy or any other type of tragedy. These ideas are very philosophical, motivational. They all belong to the life management ideas, personal development ideas, and employability ideas also. First of all, I want to urge my students, my listeners, that there is a huge gap between what we are and what we can be. So once we fill the gap between what we are and what we can be, once this gap is filled, automatically many problems will automatically stand resolved. We should give 100% of ourselves. We should live in our best form. We should leave no stone unturned in solving the problems. Another idea that is based on that, we should focus 100% on our dreams. Since we have entered this very world with dreams, ambitions, so we have vision and mission both. Our vision and mission helps us fulfill our dreams. So while realizing our dreams, we should focus on 100% performance. As our previous orator has revealed, that ultimately only our actions are counted and nothing else. There are two universal truths in this world. The very first truth, the person or thing which has entered, which is born in this very universe, will die someday. And another universal truth about our life is that whatever we do, its results will automatically change us wherever we flee. Wherever we go, we can flee across the seven seas, seven oceans, but of the results of our actions will change us. So first of all, let us cherish purity of ideas leads to purity of actions, and purity of actions bring purity of results, that is success. If our ideas are impure, if we are prejudiced physically, mentally, ideologically, spiritually, certainly we are not going the best of ourselves. So focus 100% on our dreams, give your best. There must be no leniency while performing the actions. Live life in your individual nature. Generally, we copy others. And while copying others, we lose our individuality. That is our fault. We can become perfect and ideal and iconic only practicing our individual nature. So let us be perfect in our individual nature and live life vibrantly. It is said, change your attitude. Once we change, our literary philosophical ideas tell us that we should change 1% daily. And once we change 1% daily, we change 365% in a year. Absolute change prevails over our personality within a year. Within a year, we can become a revolutionary person. So change our attitude. Once we change our attitude, everything will be automatically changed. Prove that we are in this world to prove the things, to prove our existence. Since pandemic has challenged our existence, so we have to prove that our, especially this, the focus of my sentence is on students. It is said that there is a problem of unemployment in India. But my definition of unemployment is a different one. Only those students are unemployed who are not able to prove their degree, who are not able to prove their credentials, who are not able to prove their skill. The student who proves the degree, his skill, he is never unemployed. So our student have to prove that their mark sheet is not only the receipt. It is said the mark sheets have become receipts. Receipts for what? Receipts for which their parents and guardians have paid their fee. So until and unless the students prove their mark sheet will remain as receipts of the fee paid by their guardians. So our students have to prove. This is a challenge. We have to, literature changes the definition of the particular words. Fail. I take out the very first word, fail. Fail doesn't at all mean getting failure in life. According to the worthy son of the soil of Tamil Nadu, APJ Kalam Saab, he changed the definition of the word fail. He said, fail means, F means first, A means attempt, I means in, L means learning. Fail means first attempt in learning. So let us have modernist outlook and scientific outlook. The outlook full of skilled ideas, smartness. Our students have smartphones, but their smartness is missing. That is a problem. That is the problem. The greatest persons of our India, just like Vivekanand, just like Kalam Saab also, they never had smartphones, but they were smart persons here. So instead of getting a smartphone, becoming smart in ourselves, in our individuality, that is a better thing our students should choose. Earning of sin father and self, there are three kinds of earning we are proud of. The earning of sin, that is highly condemnable. The earning of our father, we become egoistic on our father's earning. But we should be always be proud of our own earning. So there are three kinds of earning: earning of sin, earning of father, and earning of self. We should cherish right values, right ideas, right things, thinking that one day we will earn the things, otherwise we will be called parasites also. Kalam Sahib also defines end, E-end. We generally become hopeless and disappointed. End means, E means effort, N means never, or D means dies. End means effort never dies. This is the meaning. So we should live with the changed definitions of the words and abbreviations. No also. We should define the word no. Wherever we go, people say no, no. So no means when we face with this no problem. So no means next, N-O, next opportunity. In this way, we can feel ourselves blessed out of the highly ideological, philosophical definitions of life. Literature gives faith. Literature provides ideas, and ideas impart faith on your wings. Let us have faith on our wings, with which we can soar in the sky of ambitions. Literary ideas emphasize on acceptance of challenges as God-given opportunities. Challenges or tragedies, they come in disguise, or we should accept and invite challenges as God-given opportunities. Though we understand that this pandemic tragedy, we have suffered hugely out of this pandemic tragedy, but we have learned and invented many things also. We have evolved several alternative ways of thinking also. So every tragedy comes as a God-given opportunity also. So let us explore opportunities in tragedies also. Let us develop this type of outlook, which every literature teaches us. We have to learn the education of turning misfortunes into opportunities. We have learned such techniques, such philosophical ideas, out of which we turn misfortunes into opportunities. We have to emerge as massive doer. Actually, what happens, the tragedy with the human beings is that we talk too much and do little. So only those persons are remembered, those who are massive doer, not massive talker. Literature is the search of happiness in defeat. If we are defeated, we should search for happiness out of our defeat, and success by sacrifice. Literature teaches us that we can achieve success by sacrifice, not by resources. Only resources can prove luxuries of life. And once we try to live in the luxuries of life, we become the weaker human beings. So we have to emerge as stronger human beings. So we have to live by sacrifices, not by resources. It is said that life is what we give to it. If during this very tragedy, we give sorrows, unhappiness, disappointments, depressing thoughts, and we feel as suppressed and oppressed souls also, certainly it will be wrong on our behalf. It will be an insult to literary ideas also. So improve our ways of giving the ideas to ourselves. It is said, life is what we give to ourselves. So give better ideas, better thoughts, better attitude, better actions to your life. And it is said that options beacon our will. We are not the persons of weakened will. We have to emerge as persons of determined wills also. Three things in life. Since we belong to life and literature, three things in life are very much valuable, provided a true teacher tries to understand those three things in the right perspective. Every word is valuable. Every word of any language is valuable. The words have magical powers. Every plant is valuable because every plant gives a remedy, a treatment to some serious problems of life. It's the substance of the plants give works as a treatment to some great disease. And the third person is man. No man is to be counted easily. Everybody, man enters this very universe with a different types of talents. So we have to utilize the talent of every human beings. We have to recognize and identify his talent also. So every bird, every plant, every man is capable in the hands of experts, in the hands of gurus. Otherwise, we will reject the power, magical power of birds, plants, and human beings. Another thing which I want to discuss is that lack of self-awareness is the greatest defeat, is the biggest defeat. When we don't know ourselves fully, 100%, this lack of consciousness and awakened consciousness is the real objective of any literature of life. So lack of self-awareness is very harmful, and it gives only defeat and defeat and defeat. So let us come out of our comfort zones, because once we fix ourselves in the comfort zone, our human potential, our possible alternative ways of thinking and actions, they remain hidden behind the curtain. So come out of your comfort zone. Even it is also said that if pandemic is our enemy, so it is said about enemies also, good enemies are essential for success also. Because enemies give us jolt. Enemies challenge our existence. Enemies force us to give our 100% while fighting the battle of our lives. So good enemies are also essential for our success. Living with fear. In this very tragedy, we are living with fear. It is very bad. It is a negative thought. We should relieve ourselves of all the negative things in our life also. Only then we can handle the problems of pandemic also. So living with fear is killing our own prudence. God is above all. Once God is in heaven, nothing is wrong with us. So as long as God is above us, there is nothing, there is no hurdle in this world. If there are only challenges, there are not problems, and challenges are to be fought. So don't believe in the lines. Some people think that there is not a line of fate on their palm. So I would like to share my idea. Don't believe in the lines of our palms, but in the power of our hands. Our hand, God has given us our body organs, physical organs. Those are very capable. God has given us senses, and our senses are very powerful. We should utilize all of us, the power of our senses and power of our body organs, and we will become an empowered personality. My dear friends, our wrong choice of the pleasing, the one problem we have often seen, that we want to please all the persons of this very world. We have not that very rare capacity to please each and all. We are not here in this world to please all the persons. Even greatest persons of the world, even Gandhiji, could not please all the people of this world. So our wrong choice of pleasing all, it is not entertaining. It is highly condemnable. Instead of the real, while pleasing others, the reality of the things is hidden. And once the reality is hidden, it is the real cause of our defeat. So we choose our career. By the footprints, by reading, by going on the footprints of the great forefathers of our country. We are made for limitless. As I have already discussed, we have to develop ourselves into as unlimited personality. We are made for limitless things. We are made for infinite things. So breaking all the human limitations is our duty. Excellence. We are excellent human species. So we have to create excellence in this universe also. So according to Aristotle, excellence is what we do repeatedly. So whatever is our dream, whatever is our vision and mission, we should concentrate 100% on it, and we can create excellence once we do repeatedly. One more thing, I think the musician director, Mr. A.R. Rahman, he is also from Tamil Nadu. Once he has written a motivational idea that we should work 10,000 hours on our dream. And once we work 10,000 hours on our dream, on our objective of life, on our goal of life, nobody can defeat us. If there is only single post in that very area, we can have employment out of that very single post. That is the motto of A.R. Rahmanji. So we have to develop ourselves into in an infinite human being, limitless human being of human potentialities by breaking limitations. My dear friends, keep your self-esteem always high. Generally, we emerge as defeated persons. We speak the language of the defeated persons. Rather, we have to keep our self-esteem always high. We are what our thoughts are. Actually, what are we in our life? We are what the standard of our thoughts are. Once we raise the standard of our thoughts, our standard of living will be automatically increased. Fighters are brighter. The fighters have bright careers, bright professions, bright passions. We should mix passion with our profession also. This is the secret of our success in this world. So we have to add value to our life. Generally, why we are defeated? Why we emerge as a defeated person? Because we are not able to add value to our life, to add skill to our life daily. We all are money-minded. If we want to earn more money, more name, more fame, more satisfaction, we will have to add routinely, daily values to our life. The qualitative values add qualitative significance to our life, and that automatically brings life and meaningfulness to our life also. Change your vision into a mission. We have to live as a missionary's zeal. Only missionary zeal can help us. Average living, only average living cannot suffice our dream, cannot compensate our dreams also. So if we want to fulfill our dream, certainly we will have to change our vision into a mission. We have to enhance our consciousness. Already discussed the idea, enhancing our consciousness is the substance, is the gist of all our epical literature, all the scriptures. So work and work, that is the worship. Work is worship, that is the idea of our Gita, that is the idea of all literature. So let our results tell others. We weaken our will, we weaken our determined will, because before getting success, we reveal our idea, what we want to become. It weakens our idea. So rather we should tell, our results should tell others what we actually wanted to do. We have, certainly, we have become excusitis. We pretend a lot. Excuses won't make our life great. So we have to deprive ourselves of all the excuses. It is not going to help the pandemic tragedies also. We have to give performances, bright performance, miraculous performance, wonderful performance on the right vision, right idea, right actions. We have to explore a strong reason. There should be some strong reason why we should live in this very world. If we don't have a strong reason behind our actions, certainly our actions will be loose. So explore some strong reason behind our living, behind our birth for living. Keep the remote. Certainly we give remote of our life to others. So others control our life. In this way, we waste our creative energies. So just to have 100% control on our mind, body, and soul, we have to keep the remote of our life in our hands. Those who try never fail. We have to evolve each day. We have to be judgmental. We have to be experimental. Once we try daily, we get experiences daily. And once we get experiences daily, we never fail. We fail because due to lack of matured experiences. Let us live our dreams, because once we get a human life, let us live our dreams, not fears. What happens? Generally, what happens? We spoil our present by living in fears, as a fearful soul, as a suppressed soul. 90% of our fears are imaginative. In reality, they never happen. So we should know this very scientific idea. Let us live our dreams, not fears. Think over how to become a better human. The whole exercise, the whole education, the whole substance of all literature is how to become a better human being. We should think over this very idea. There is a lot of rubbish things inside in our personality. So until and unless we remove whatever is rubbish in our thoughts, in our actions, we can't succeed in our life. So throw rubbish which resides inside ourselves as soon as possible. Circumstances aren't in our control. We know. Generally, people say that we are slave to circumstances, but we should add one more sentence also. Yes, we do know that we are slave to circumstances. circumstances aren't in our control, but we can control our situations and our conditions in the given circumstances, and we can emerge winners also. Either search, we are divine sons and daughters of our country, sons and daughters of our nature, darling, sons and daughter of our God. So either search divinity, either search divinity, either search divinity or live a rubbish life. There is a disturbance on your behalf also. Somebody's mic is open, so just control.
I am going to finish
within 10 or 15 minutes. Ma'am, am I allowed to speak?
Yes, please proceed, sir.
Generally, what happens with we human beings, we settle to live an average life. Living average life is not going to solve our lively problems. We have to live unique life, miraculous life, divine life, because we happen to be the divine sons and daughters of our soil, of our country, of our nation, of our God also. We should know search for divinity is also the ultimate objective of literature. So give your best. Give your best. Don't compromise life. Don't compromise life too much to please all. It is not our duty to please all. While pleasing all, we ingloriously are not able to please all. Their attitude is conditioned and different circumstances, so we cannot please all the people all the time everywhere. We have to work on our mission. Excellent career is the best gift to all. If we emerge as a person of excellent career, excellent profession, we can please our nation, our society, our community, our parents also, ourselves also, and to God also. So it is the ultimate motto of our life to get excellent life. That will be the best gift, best ever gift given to our society. There are no big problems in society. There are only challenges. I have already told, the fault is not in our fate. What is our fate? What is destiny? The collective results of our previous actions is our fate. So we should not see, we should not read our lines on our palm, the lines of our fate. Only those people are also the destined people, the fated people, who don't have palms also, who don't have hands also. So there are no problems in this society. There are only challenges. One more thing. There are 6 demerits of human beings which spoil our energy, which provide defeat to our career and possibilities. The one demerit of our personality is sleeping more than desired, because time is the most precious thing of our life. So if we sleep too much and even too less also, it is going to disturb our life. We cannot take out the maximum out of the given 24 hours. We repent over our past. That is also problematic in human life. We spoil our present. Our present is the most precious gift given by God. So we spoil our present by thinking too much of our past. We bring our past into our present and spoil this precious present of today. We are always worried over our future, worried for our future also. That is also not in our hand. Once we give 100% performance to our today, there will be no problem of repentance, and automatically our future will be bright and fruitful. So comparison, and another thing I want to share with my student, comparison is our disappointing failure. Every individual is a masterpiece, is an excellent human being. So we should develop our individuality instead of comparing ourselves with others. If we compare ourselves with others, sooner or later, it will weaken our fighting spirit. We people have prejudiced mind, and keeping prejudiced mind is the breeder of thousands of problems. We face thousands of problems because our minds are prejudiced. That's why we want purity of mind, purity of body, purity of heart, and purity of soul. Only then pure ideas will come out of our soul, our mind, body, and soul, and pure ideas will have pure actions as a result, and we will emerge as a successful human being. Change the attitude, change the universe. If the universe of our life is not changing, if we are not moving towards success, certainly there is fault in our pattern of thinking. So change the attitude and change the universe. Qualities, I was sharing 6 faults of our personality. The one is sleeping too much or too less. The second is yawning. We should sleep or we should wake. But yawning is a process in which we do nothing. The third is fear. Fear, 90% of our fear is full of imaginative. Fear kills our prudence, our wisdom. Anger. Sometimes our anger, just like Durvasa says, our anger spoils our lifelong relationship also. Laziness is the biggest enemy of a person's life. And the last one is procrastination. We procrastinate the things. Whatever we can do now, we should do now. We should not procrastinate the things to tomorrow or the times to come. So don't do everything, but be expert of some. Only experts of things are very much in demand. This is the age of marketing. And in this age of marketing, only subject experts are very much in demand. So don't do everything just to please all, but be expert of something, expert of one thing, which is very much in demand. Comparison is in our disappointment. I have already told, comparison is our disappointing failure. Another idea, qualities of a student. What are the qualities of a good student? Eating less. If we eat too much, it brings loathsome. It brings laziness. So once eat less, number two, leaving the house. We will have to leave our house to get knowledge. Crow-like endeavors. You must have heard the story of a thirsty crow. So we have to endeavor just like a crow. Crow brought pebbles and put into that very pitcher, which had a little water, and he drank it. Dog-like sleep. Our sleep should be just like dog. And our attention should be just like heron. That is called bako dhyanam in this way. Once we face adversities, it is said that adversities breed miracles. Miracles happen out of the adversities, and adversity lies the head that bears the crown. My dear friends, whatever input we feed in our mind, body and soul, that type of output we will get. If we are not satisfied with the output of our career, we should change the input. As is the input, so is the output. Think over it deeply. If we follow the crowd, we are not here in this world to follow the crowd. If we follow the crowd, you will become the crowd in your life. So what we have to do? We have to be a man in the crowd, a leader in the crowd. We have to develop rare capacity to question the things, because capacity to asking questions is the foundation of human progress. We should ask serious questions. That is the foundation of human progress. Don't sow rubbish in your mind. If we sow rubbish things in our mind, we will reap the harvest of rubbishness. Don't do that, rare people do. Because we are rare human species. We are that species out of God has created crores of millions of species. And out of those human species is the divine one, miraculous one. So we are miraculous human beings to do rare things. We, as a rare human being, as a rare species of this very universe, we should do as rare people think, and rare actions will bring rare results. That is the success. We have to be transparent in our ideas. There is no problem in this world, because there are problems in this world because we have opaque ideas. We have dim ideas. So be clear in your perspectives, objectives. Workers, not circus. This universe strongly needs workers, not circus. If we are circus, we are not going to achieve anything valuable in our life. If we fail to plan, this is a very celebrated idea. If we fail to plan, we plan to fail. If we fail in our life, certainly we should know that our planning was loose. So we should work more on planning than on action. Ideas, my dear friends, ideas rule the world. So let us develop better ideas. Let us develop best ideas, best thinking, and best perspective, best results in this way. Sacrifice is key to success. Whatever it is said that if there is no pain, no gain. So we have to do sacrifices just to get success, because it is said that sacrifice is key to success. 1 minute thinking. We should change our thinking patterns. We should have revolutionary ideas. Because 1 minute thinking can change life as a whole. Too much thinking, it is also a Hamletian disease. Hamlet thought too much, that's why he was killed. So too much thinking, brooding over too much on any idea weakens our will, weakens our determined will. So, my dear friends, embellish your today. Decorate your today to see your better future. Time never stops, and the spent time is never returns. So, encash every moment of your life in your favor only, and emerge winners. People without hands are also destined ones. Man is the maker of his own fate. We have to be grassrooter persons, not parachuters. As I have already said, we all belong to the middle class people. So we are not given parachute to fly in the sky. we have to work as grassroots persons. Life, there is a very good idea. Life is under no obligation to give us what we expect. Life is not under an obligation to give us what we expect. What we expect in our life, we have to evolve our soul, ourselves also. We have to earn also. We get in our life what we invest, what we earn in our life. Let us have human beings of strong critical reasoning, not only superstitious people. Generally, we persons become superstitious in our nature. Superstitious nature, superstitious ideas don't bring good results. So let us have critical human beings of critical human beings. Luxury has become our problems. Sometimes our elders say that we generally have more than expected luxury facilities and the resources that has put our personality into doubt. The greatest persons of the world have been the poorest one also. So let us have a kind of poverty also. Once there is a gap of poverty, there is a problem of something in our life, only then we can value the things in the right perspective. Limited resources, we should earn a lot. Out of limited resources, we should have unlimited achievements also. We have to become role model of our society, our institutions, our professions. Don't flow with the time. Most of the people generally flow with the time. It is not a success journey. So be a role model of the time, of the society, of the community, of the nation, of your life. Be stubborn to change this world. We all are in this world to change to change the problems of this very world, to change the negativity of this very world. So be stubborn and change the world. We are average of 5 people. It is said that everybody is, whatever he is average of 5 people among whom he passes most of his time. So if our success is not changing, if we are not progressive, we should change the bad company also. Autograph taker or giver. It is also the idea given by APJ Kalam Sahab. We are not here in this world to be autograph takers. Rather, we have to be the autograph givers. Our life starts valuably only when we issue autographs to others also. When people say, "You are mad," generally, most of the people, when you are on the path of progress, most of the people will declare that you are mad, but you are on the right path. You have to prove over the period that you were on the right path. We get what we invest or what we deserve. The problem with we human beings is that what we should and shouldn't. First, we should deserve, after we should desire. But we do otherwise. First, we desire, then we deserve. That is the problem. That's why we don't succeed. Getting bored and tension is the wastage of time. If our students suffer from boredom, or if we are tense in their personal life, both the things are wastage of time. We should change our patterns of thinking and actions. Take working tension. We should take working tensions also. We have to dispose the things within the time limit, within the time framework. So we should cherish and develop working tension, not that tension that kills. That kills just like our pyre. Know yourself. Knowing ourselves is the greatest thing. Once we know ourselves, automatically all the problems of our life are resolved. My dear friends, encase each and every moment in your favor. Communication skill. Our students should learn communication skills. Once we become men and women of communication skills, most of our problems get automatically resolved. Don't wear the uniform of failures. Generally, we speak the language of failures. Generally, we wear the uniform of failures. Generally, we perform the activities with half intention. We give only half or semi performance. It is not going to give 100% results. So don't wear the uniform of failures. Willpower enhancement. Enhance your willpower, because willpower brings extra energy to our life to solve the problems, maybe pandemic problems. We have to be bold. Munshi Premchand, one of the Hindi poets, says that due to lack of boldness, 90% of people returned before stepping on the ladder of success. So don't wear the uniform of failures. Willpower enhancement will be the mission of our life. Boldness is the prerequisite thing to get any success. Any success needs 100% discipline. So be 100% disciplined person and emerge as an invincible personality. Skill development. Skill is honored everywhere, wherever we go. So skill develop ourselves into a skilled person, and a skilled person gets respect everywhere, wherever he goes. Be masterpiece. We are here in this world to be masterpiece, to be extraordinary, and as subject experts. Practice makes a man perfect. Our students should work in one field. They should aim at one thing at a time. And once we practice, and practice makes a man perfect. But again, already I have discussed the idea by Aristotle. What we do repeatedly is excellence. Again, I am repeating the idea given by A.R. Rahmanji. We should give 10,000 hours to our objectives, working hours to our objectives, and we will emerge as a masterpiece, as an extraordinary person, as a subject expert, and nobody would be able to challenge us. Practice makes a man perfect. Let us evolve, let us grow, let us develop ideologically daily. This is our daily work. This is our routine work. Be zero in ego. Ego is the biggest hurdle on the path of progress. So be zero in ego. And let us leave selfishness. Because once we practice selfishness, we are rejected from enemies. Selfishness is our greatest enemy. So let us be altruistic. Let us be modern in humanitarian outlook. Let us be generous. Let us be empathetic, sympathetic. Let us be kind and compassionate. Only then we can become rich and prosperous in this very world. We all are teachers. Teachers can create emperors of our society. Chanakya, the great prudent minister, once has written that teachers can create emperors of society and teachers can create destroyers of society also. It depends upon the ideological height of our ideas. So we have to be curious. Ultimately, the height of our actions counts. Ultimately, our actions count, our performance count, our works count. That is counted. Only actions bring fruitful results. So we have to focus 100% on our actions. simply thinking. It is also said that actions speak louder than words. And one more thing, sacrifice is the need of the hour. You might, my dear friends, you might have heard the story of Lord Shiva. He drank poison for the welfare of humanity, for the welfare of the gods and goddesses. So sometimes in our life, we have to drink poison to emerge as a Lord Shiva. Be pious of your intentions. In our personal life, we have to be pious of our intentions, our actions, and our success. Thus, whatever actions we choose, that should be purity, piety. And once we practice all these ideas, our belief, our character will be excellent. Once our thoughts are excellent, our actions will be excellent, our success will be excellent. So my dear friends, these were the some formulas, some philosophical ideas of literature. No tragedy can defeat us if we have lofty ideas. Whenever we are defeated by any tragedy, by any pandemic, certain we are crushed under the weaker standard of our thoughts. So substantially, as a gist, conclusively, I would like to my sentence, the last sentence of my speech. Thus, let us increase the ideological height of our thoughts. Once we are transparent in our thoughts, once our thoughts are transparent, certainly whatever problems we face, the problems in itself bring solutions. But the solutions are lying scattered within the problems. So we have to sort out the things. We have to prioritize the thoughts and the things just to emerge as a solution, as a solution bringing persons. If we are not solution focused persons, which another species of this very universe will be solution focused? So instead of becoming a problem focused person, we have to be solution focused persons. Once we are solution focused person, only alternative solutions will emerge, and ultimately we will win over all the problems of our life, our universe, pandemic problems, or whatever crisis or conflict we face in our life. Thank you all the organizers of this very webinar, this very lecture. These were my ideas I wanted to share with you. I want to request my students to kindly give feedback to whatever ideas, motivational ideas, ideological idea I have given. I hope and trust that once you digest these very ideas, automatically you will feel relieved of many problems, many conflicts, many debates and discussions of life. And you can live as a convenient human being, as a healthy human being, as a worthwhile human being for your family, for yourself, for your society, community, and nation, and for this very universe also. This is truly the expectation of other human beings, and this is truly the ultimate end of all the education, and this is truly the message of all the literatures. So we should cherish and digest all those valuable ideas, and we will emerge winners. Thank you very much again, all the organizers, for giving me this very opportunity to share my views. Thank you, all my friends, my students who are listening to me. They have given your feedbacks. Also, those who have not given feedback, kindly give your feedback. And if you have any question, I want to request if your students or teachers or faculty, if you have any question, you can ask me. My student can also ask me the questions, and I am ready to answer all of your questions. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Sir, thank you so much. First and foremost, thank you for your wonderful, impressive interesting, spellbound, extraordinary, exceptional session, sir. Thank you so much. It's very interesting. And you made the session very thought-provoking, sir. Let's go for
any
discussion.
Any question, if anybody asks?
Yeah. Yeah, please. Anybody wants to share your views?
The session is
please.
Open.
Girls, friends?
Somebody had asked the questions. I am reading it. My question, Dr. Sanjay Prasad Sharma. How can we evaluate our own life? Please suggest at least 3 ways to build our character. Your talk has been excellent, useful, impressive, and fruitful. Organizers have done a great work to organize such a wonderful webinar, especially Dr. Sumati, Dr. V. Anuradha, principal of the college, and the rest of others are thankful. This is Dr. Sanjay Prasad Sharma, associate professor of English, UP India. Thank you, Dr. Sanjay, for asking this very relevant question. I will try to give my own perspective while giving answer to your question. How can we evaluate our own life? Dr. Sanjay, there is no single formula with which we can evaluate our life. In our shastras and scriptures and religious books, whatever moments we live for others, that those are pressure moments, and we are always judged by others. So we should live for others. While living for oneself, we should live for others also. And only those moments are valuable which we live for others. What are the character building ideas? We should do one difficult work daily. And while doing the impossible things, the difficult thing, once we practice doing it daily, certainly within a year, we will have very strong character. Generally, what happens, all the human beings, they remain aloof from the reality. In every situation, there are two things. Once there are pleasing things, we practice. And the another thing is that the real things. So instead of performing in pleasing circumstances with pleasing things, we should know the reality. We should work on the real issues. And once we work on real issues, some may get angry for the time being, but ultimately we will emerge as winner. The third thing, we can develop our strong character in this way also, that they are human being and kites. These two things, when they face odd situation, when they face different air, kites and human beings, when they have opposite air facing, opposite wind flowing against them, they emerge more powerful. So facing all the struggles of life, all the challenging situations of life, life is full of struggle. So let us invite struggles also. I was always a fighter, so one fight more, the best is yet to be. So these are the things. There are other things also, Dr. Sanjay, which I can share, but lack of time. Whatever ideas I have given, I think those are the real ideas with which we can fight and evaluate our life also. And let us evaluate, let us prove a true person in the eyes of others. We all are good in our own eyes. So when others give judgment in our favor, so the only then we are good, we are worthwhile and valuable human beings. Thank you very much. Anybody else? Another question?
Thank you, Amar Singh, for your very wonderful session. It's very impressive and interesting.
Thank you, all the organizers and ma'am to you. Thank you.
It was very spellbound. And right from the session started till the last moment, it was very, very informative. Very informative. And this is need of the hour also. The every single word you uttered, it's the need of the hour for this current generation, especially for our children, for our students. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Anybody, friends, would you like to share your views? Shall I ask Vishnu to propose vote of thanks, ma'am? Shall I ask Vishnu to invite Hema, ma'am?
Yes.
Vishnu, yes, are you here, Vishnu?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Many, many have voiced their opinion in the chat box.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Today is something unique. Now, many students, they have come forward. Usually, they are very quiet and very dumbstruck. And this is the very first time they have come with their own opinions and they have shared their views in the chat box.
I should say that is my success, ma'am.
Yes, sir. It is because of you made...
That is my real feedback, ma'am.
Yes, sir. The credit goes to you, sir. You have made our children to think. The session was very, very thought-provoking. As our HOD has mentioned in her views, she has mentioned clearly it's a very thought-provoking. So you made the session very thought-provoking and interesting. Thank you, sir. Vishnu, would you please proceed?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Gratitude makes sense of our past, brings peace for today, and creates a vision for tomorrow. Yes, it's time to propose vote of thanks. I take immense pleasure in inviting Professor P. Hemalatha, a distinguished and dynamic personality of our department, to propose vote of thanks. Hema, ma'am.
Start my video. Vishnu Priya,
thank you, Ms. Vishnu Priya.
Thank you, ma'am.
To everybody. I deem this an illustrious prestige and honor to express my wholehearted gratitude to our chief guest, Dr. Amar Singh, Professor and Head, Department of English, Government Autonomous PG Lead College, Chintwara, Madhya Pradesh, for sparing his precious time in spite of his busy schedule and enlightened our minds with his excellent speech on the role of literature and life management in pandemic. Literature plays a predominant role in helping to overcome the pandemic crisis. He quoted from various literary figures, from Aristotle to Browning and even the modern writers. And he reminded of Milton's precious lines, "The mind is its place and in itself can make a heaven of hell and a hell of heaven." Thank you so much, sir, for adorning the third day of this national level seminar series by your impressive lecture. We are also reminded of Milton's lines, "Although the field is lost, nothing is lost. The indomitable courage, the unconquerable will, and never to submit or yield." Thank you so much, sir. Leadership is the capacity to translate the vision into reality. Yes, I take this opportunity to record my sincere thanks to our respected principal for her continuous support, encouragement, and motivation. Showing gratitude is the simplest and, of course, the most powerful, meaningful thing which a human being can do for each other. I wish to express my wholehearted thanks to the convener of this seminar, Dr. G.S. Angelin, Associate Professor and Head, Department of English, Dindigul, for her sustaining support to make this seminar a successful one. Thankfulness is the memory of the heart. Yes, I am immensely pleased to thank the Organizing Secretary, Dr. K.M. Sumathi, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Dindigul, for her enduring efforts to organize the seminar successfully. I extend my sincere thanks to all the faculty members for their tremendous support and cooperation to make this seminar a resounding success. It's my pleasure to thank all the participants from the parental institution and from other institutions all over the nation for their active and enthusiastic participation and their valuable feedback. It will be incomplete if I fail to recognize or acknowledge the technical support rendered by our lecturers of the department. For without them, this virtual seminar would have been a dream. உருமாறி நம் வாழ்வை தடுமாற வைத்து இவ்வுலகையே ஆட்டி படைக்கும் கொரோனா என்ற அரக்கனை எதிர்கொள்வோம் இலக்கியம் கொடுக்கும் மன வலிமையின் துணை கொண்டு. To put it in English, let's march towards success with the help of literature and literary ideas to sweep the demon corona which threatens and makes the world tumble with this new mutation and new variants. God is in heaven and all is well with the world. Indeed. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you so much.
Message, WhatsApp, 60.
Thank you, Hema. Thank you so much for your vote of thanks. Dr. Rama Singh, thank you so much for joining us. हेलो
जी
कैन यू हियर मी सर थैंक यू सो मच सर विल कीप इन टच विद यू यस मैम आर यू ऑडिबल मैम मैम वुड यू लाइक टू से एनीथिंग मैम
नो 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 यू आर ऑडिबल आई सेड
ओके 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 आई थॉट आई सेड ओके यस सर डॉक्टर अमर सिंह सर विल कीप इन टच विद यू एंड विल कीप इनवाइटिंग यू फॉर द अदर सेमिनार्स आल्सो In short,
Jim. Anuradha ma'am is speaking.
Dr. Angelin. Dr. Angelin is on the line. She is the head of the department. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. So Thank nice. We will be in touch.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Definitely. Thanks. Definitely. So nice. Thank okay. you, sir.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Jim.